going to place a pin at the intersection before the change of the neckline, angle it down. Draw the new shoulder. And then move the pin to the at the end of the shoulder, and we're going to angle it back to meet the trace line. And if you ignore that line I just drew, let's see here, here we go. I'm getting a little bit straighter. You can see you can keep the same on the back piece, but then this would be taped to your pattern, and you'd see the shape of the armhole just like the body, angled a little bit more. My guess is if you have square shoulders, this illustration shows square shoulders where the fabric raises at the neckline because the bone structure is higher than the shape of the pattern. We're then going to trace the pattern. And trace it. And if you're going to have the shoulder higher, we'll measure above 4 or 1/2 of an inch, place a pin at the neck where the stitching lines cross, and pivot this upward. And then draw the raised shoulder. Move the pin, keep it pivoted at the shoulder where the stitching lines cross, and move it back. So if you want to practice this on your mini patterns, you do the same alteration on the front as well as on the back. And there you can see how the shoulder has all been hiked up and it will fit the sleeve just perfectly. Sway back. That measurement is listed on the back of the envelope with bust, waist, hip, and back length. And here's how you measure the back length. Again, your sewing machine will have to help you do this measurement from the neck to your waistline.
Okay.